obviously the designation of the conservation area boundaries down one side of Lindale Road and not the other. That is almost irrelevant in some ways because the fact that the other side of the road is not within the conservation area, any development on that side of the road could be argued to affect the setting of the conservation area. Cumulatively, there would be undoubtedly an impact if the council allowed significant developments, significant proportions of flatting developments moving forward that subsequently could then be taken to change the character of the area. I think the difference with this proposal is the applicant themselves have alluded to the property on the other side of the road has been converted into three apartments. There are apartments here. This is the property that has been converted into three. And further up there is at the end of the road more apartments. But substantially, this road is still made up of single residential properties. We have had regards to the Mountain Lion Conservation Area appraisal and the management plan and what both of those documents say in that regard. And it's our view that this small number of units on this plot wouldn't detrimentally impact on the character of the conservation area at this time. But as members will be aware, each application is taken on its individual merit. And I think if we were to see an increased number of proposals to convert applications into apartments along this stretch of Lindale Road, or indeed anywhere else in the conservation area, then we may take a different view. But I think at this point in time, we don't feel that four apartments would impact on the character of the conservation area. The design of the property is such that it looks externally like a single residential dwelling, but obviously the use of the property as an apartment building rather than a single dwelling would impact on character as well. But our view at this moment in time is that it is sufficiently unchanged that it wouldn't warrant a reasonable refusal. But we would have to look at that in the future if any future applications come in.
Okay,
James.
Yes, thank you, Chair. I think our network manager, Chapley, has very eloquently answered the $64,000 question, which is that our current planning policy with regard to parking would not allow us to refuse this on those grounds. We would go straight to appeal. The appeal inspector would look at our lack of control of the parking and immediately turn down any refusal. This again puts forward my reading for wanting a rapid change in the examination of what would be allowed in the way of parking. Because if it goes to keep occurring more and more often, the application could come to change houses or larger dwellings into flats or try and turn buildings of whatever sort without adequate parking being provided. Of course, we all want to follow Patrick's idea that we follow a sustainable route and we don't go driving around in cars, but we have to inject a note of realism into this. People would buy cars, people would have cars, and people would want to park cars. And it's irrelevant to suggest that you're going to stop them doing it unless you're going to put 100% tax on anybody who purchases a car and increase petrol to £100 a litre. So whilst you have to accept these things, we have to be realistic. We have to make meaningful decisions which take into account the fact that in this area, the likelihood is that anybody occupying those flats is going to have certainly one car and possibly two. And if we don't make provision for them within the curtilage of the site, they're going to spill out onto the road. If they spill out onto the road, they are bound to cause
beyond 25% of the number of properties in a road were given over to apartments, then you could start to form an argument that the character of an area is changing. But given that this is only the third in this road, I'm not sure that we've got a very strong reason that would stand up robustly in that view.
Just a quick observation. It is 25% of the numbers arguing that the character of the road were changed, and then the argument falls on that. So I come back to this conversation.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, Chair.
It's just over 12 months when this came up on our last occasion, we had a site visit, and we, as the planning committee, refused it. It's not greatly changed in the footprint, although it's been moved a little bit. I don't want to go into traffic problems and so on, but you've got a very dangerous road, Mel's Drive, with the residential school just at the top end, and if you're around there at 9 o'clock or 4 o'clock, you just can't breathe. It's very near impossible, and certainly in the summer. I do come to a situation where I would be cross the teeth, put the dots in the right place, because I'm not at all happy with it. And if I could think of a wording of a refusal, I certainly would come up with. And I can't, I'm just going to ask, is it any wording that you can call refusal? Because if we have a review and we get overruled again, it's a silly situation. I just don't know which direction to go into. And personally, the T's have not crossed, the dust's not in the right place, but I can't give an excuse why we can call refusal. Thank you.
Okay, we've had Cathy and Eddie have moved that we refuse this application. All those in favour of refusal?
Anybody against? And any abstentions?
If it's 6-0, doesn't the chair have to say how many is in the custom? Yeah. It was just a problem, wasn't it? 6-0, I thought. It'll
feel good, I believe.
Yeah, I know. But Paclair abstained.
Yeah, so that's 6, 7,
8,
3, 6.
That's what's causing the delay.
Okay, that was actually a vote of 6-6, so the position that we're in is that the motion to refuse has been lost and we need to go back to the original recommendation. So I need to go back to the original recommendation, and those who are in favour can show their hand.
Just
going
to simply advise that one, because if a vote is already passed, is there a precedent that we go back and take the vote?
Chair, that's a casting vote.
We're re-rolling the vote that's already taken place. I've never seen it happen.
You want to change your mind?
We're in a few minutes.
But doesn't the chair have a casting vote? To approve, what I suppose it. What's the difference?
The original motion to approve was lost. We then had a motion to refuse, which was lost. So we do not have a decision of this committee, and we need to have a decision of our committee to move forward.
Well, surely that's a
okay,
change casting
so
vote.
We had, sorry, Councillor Blakely, you're not.
I know I'm not, I'm just looking at it constitutionally. I know you lot don't approve of the constitution.
Paul, if I can just say that lawfully we do have to make a decision. And that's why we need to go back to the
House, we haven't made a decision on that's why
appeals for non-determination are not subject to the council. Their decisions that are taken by the applicant. That's why the applicant seeks for an appeal against non-determination because the council hasn't determined the application within a given time frame. This is a different situation because the committee are not, well, they're appealing to refuse to make a decision. It's not the same as not having a decision. So more than the council must make a decision on this application.
Okay.
answer you want, in other words.
Paul, are you satisfied with the answer that you want?
Well, I don't agree with the advice.
Well, whether you agree with it or not, is it around the way you...
The penalty sheet us.
Yeah, thank you. Okay, so we've got, Denise is going to move this, and we have a second of approval. All those in favour of approval? numbers we love for. Okay, thank you, that's carried. Okay, we're going to go to item 18 on the agenda, and this item seeks to gain members' approval for planning applications decided on the delegated powers between the 12th of August and the 14th of September. Are there any comments from members?
No.
Can we note this report?
Yes.
Thank you. Okay, we do have one item of urgent business, which is the technical consultation on planning. But before we go to that, I'm afraid I need a pee, so I'm going to have to go. Okay, so do excuse me.
I want to get to the dentist. We should have a vice chair for checking.
Can we adjourn 5 minutes, please? I'm not desperate to rush there.